Namaskar, Anuhasnika. Welcome to the special session on Diwali at Swami Vivekanand Cultural Center at the Embassy of India, Seoul. Diwali or Deepavali is celebrated as one of the largest festivals in India, and it has also spread to other countries across the globe. The festival gets its name from the Sanskrit word Deepavali, meaning rows of lighted lamps. The Festival of Lights, as it is popularly known, goes beyond cultures and borders. It follows the lunar calendar and lasts for 5 days, usually falling in October or November of the year. The first day, known as Dhanteras, is dedicated to cleaning homes and purchasing small items of gold. The second day, called Naraka Chaturdashi or Choti Diwali, commemorates Krishna's destruction of Narakasura. Prayers are also offered for the souls of ancestors. On the third day, families seek blessings from Goddess Lakshmi to ensure their prosperity, light diyas, candles and fireworks. It is the main day of the Diwali festival. The fourth day is celebrated as Govardhan Puja, Bali Pratipada or Anakut, and is the start of the new year in the Vikram Hindu calendar. Merchants perform religious ceremonies and open new account books. The fifth day, called Bhai Dooj, Bhai Tika or Bhai Beej, celebrates the bond between brothers and sisters. While the precise historical origins of Diwali are difficult to trace, some of the festival's most commonly narrated stories, arising from the deep mythology of the Indian subcontinent, may help shed light on the rich, eternal, diverse nature of the festival. People interpret the Diwali story based upon where they live, but there is one common theme no matter where they celebrate: the victory of good over evil. There are many myths and legends associated with the festival that go back centuries. The most prominent legend associated with Diwali is that of Rama's return to Ayodhya, according to the Ramayana. As legend has it, Lord Rama returned to Ayodhya after 14 years of exile. To welcome them, the people of Ayodhya cleaned their houses and placed oil lamps to light their path. This is the reason people today decorate their homes with lights, diyas and candles and burst crackers to celebrate the return of their king. The second legend is about the rebirth of Lakshmi. As the story goes, God Indra once provoked Goddess Lakshmi to leave the divine world and enter the ocean. In her absence, the world turned into a dark place. The gods then churned the ocean to bring her back, after which Goddess Lakshmi was finally reborn, bringing her blessings of good fortune to the world. On Diwali, people light up the night to guide Lakshmi into their home to bring good fortune and prosperity for the year to come. The third legend is about Krishna's victory. In the southern part of India, the story of Lord Krishna's victory over demon Narakasura also holds particular significance to Diwali. Legend says that the powerful demon King Narakasura was defeated by Lord Krishna and his wife Satyabhama. Narakasura, before his death, requested that no one should mourn his death, but instead celebrate his death with colorful light, as we see every year during the Diwali festival. The fourth legend is about Goddess Kali destroying the demons. Kali, the goddess of destruction, is celebrated in West Bengal as the major deity associated with Diwali. According to Hindu mythology, Kali was born to liberate heaven and earth from the cruel oppression of the demons. However, after slaying all the demons, Kali lost control and continued her path of destruction until the intervention of Lord Shiva reined her in. Her day of repentance is celebrated on Diwali, paying tribute to the awesome power of Kali and her embodiment of the ultimate victory of good over evil. While these previous legends come from Hindu mythology, Jains also have their own traditions that guide the celebration of Diwali. For the Jain community, the festival commemorates the enlightenment and liberation, moksha, of Mahavira from the cycle of life and death, samsara. The lighting of the lamp celebrates the light of Mahavira's holy knowledge. Sikhs also hold their own version of Diwali, Bandi Chhor Diwas, which they celebrate in a similar way alongside Hindus and Jains. In Sikh tradition, this date commemorates the 17th century release of Guru Har Gobind from prison, who had been detained under the Mughal Empire. It is also a time of year during which all Sikhs traditionally gather to receive Guru blessings and has officially been observed as a Sikh festival since the 17th century. Whether you are a believer of these legends and stories or not, there is one thing you're sure to do on Diwali, and that is to celebrate it with lights. Homes, streets, parks, and most importantly, people's hearts are illuminated with a warm golden glow during the festival season. And this is what brings the entire country together during the festival season. Happy Diwali! Now, Mr. Avijit Chakravarti, Kathak instructor at Swami Vivekanand Cultural Center, Seoul, will represent a dance recital on Deepavali, Mahalakshmi Stotram.